Hi there, welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, our second video on linear inequalities as graph regions. A skill I need you super good at, and something we've done previously on Hegarty Maths, is drawing straight lines. I would like you to pause the video, and for each of these three, could you draw the straight line on the axes provided? Okay, you should have got the following as your straight lines. Now, if you're not so familiar with drawing those straight lines, or you look at that and can't see where I get the answers from, please go back to your building blocks for this. We need you super good at that particular skill to do this one on linear inequalities. Right, let's get straight into it with an example. Pause the video and have a go if you think you can do this. So we're asked to identify the region R satisfied by the inequality y is strictly less than x. So what we're going to do is draw the line y is equal to x. But we're going to draw that with a dotted line because it's a strict inequality. So drawing the line y is equal to x, remember, all the points where x equals y. It's going to be a straight line like that. And we're going to do it down this side as well. And we're going to make sure we make it a dotted line, because it's a strict inequality. And there you go, we have the line y is equal to x, but we've made it a dotted line. Now we want to shade or identify the region R satisfied by the inequality. Now, a little trick for these, especially when they're going to get more complicated, we're going to shade what we don't want, and what's left over, we're going to label it as R. That's because we're going to eventually do questions where there's lots of shading going on, and if we shade everything that we do want, we're going to have a big mess of a picture. So we're going to shade what we don't want and label the thing that we do want, the region we're interested in, with the letter R. Now, what do we want? We want all the Y numbers that are always less than the x number. So they're going to be below this graph here. That's what we want. Okay, so we're going to call this region R here, and we're going to shade everything we don't want. This stuff here, we don't want this time. So we're shading what we don't want. And that there is the region we're interested in. Now pick any coordinate in that region as a point test. Test that point there, the point x is 2 and y is 1. And is it true that 1 is less than 2? It is, and therefore this is the right region I have labeled as R, and we're done. So that's a tiny little bit different than the first video. We were asked in the first video to shade certain regions. This time we're asked to identify the region R, so we're asked to label it R. So we're going to use this little trick of shading the thing we don't want and leaving clean the thing we do want and labeling it up R. Okay, let's have a go at another one. Pause the video, have a go at this one. Now firstly, we're going to draw the line y is equal to negative x, which we should know looks something like this. It's a straight line going in that direction there. And it's going to be a full line, not a dotted line, because we have a bigger than or equal to negative x. So that's the line y is equal to negative x, like that. And we want the y values that are bigger than negative x. On this line, all the y values equals negative x. We want the y values bigger than negative x. So we want above the line here. We're going to call that one R, the region we're interested in, and we're going to shade what we don't want below the line like that. And that's the region we're interested in, the one R here. Now, just before you move on, it's always easy to make a mistake here. Just test a particular point. That point there is the coordinates x is negative 2, y is 3. Now, let's double check. Is it true that 3 is bigger than or equal to negative 2? Yes, it is. 3 is bigger than or equal to 2. That negative negative 2 is positive 2. So that seems like it's in the region we're looking for, and we're done. Let's have a go at another one. Pause the video, have a go at this. We're going to draw the line x plus y is equal to 4. Now, you should be able to draw this from your work on drawing straight lines. With things like this, I said what you can think of is you can just imagine x being 0, so that being 0, and at the same time you would get y as 4, so that line goes through 0, 4. And then you could imagine that y was equal to 0, right? Imagine y was 0, then x would be equal to 4 at that point. So it would go through 4, 0. So it would go through 4, 0, which is here. It would go through 0, 4, which is here, and the straight line would go between the two. So we can just draw it like that. Okay? Now, this time we're not going to have a dotted line. We're going to have a full line because it's less than or equal to 4. Now, these are all the points where x plus y is equal to 4. We want to identify the region R where x plus y is less than 4. That's going to be, because it's less than, below the graph. So that's going to be there. So we're going to shade what we don't want in this particular case, and we don't want anything above the line. Now let's test a point. That point there is the point 1, 2. Let's test it's true that 1 add 2 is less than or equal to 4. Indeed it is. 1 add 2 is 3, which is less than or equal to 4. So it seems like we've got the right region. Another one. Pause the video, have a go at that. Okay, step 1, draw the line y is equal to 2x subtract 3. That, if we're trying to draw this line y equals 2x subtract 3, we know two things. We know that the gradient is 2, and we know that the y-intercept is going to be 0, negative 3. And that's all we need to draw these. So start at 0, negative 3, and take a gradient of 2. So as I go to the right one, I go up 2. As I go to the right one, I go up 2. Right 1, up 2. Right 1, up 2. And we're going to get ourselves our straight line there that looks something like this. Now, do we want a dotted or a full line? Well, we're going to want a dotted line because it's a strict inequality. So make sure we do a dotted line, and we'll drop some marks there. And on this line here, this is the line y is equal to 2x subtract 3. They're all the points where y is equal to that. We want the y's that are bigger than this. So we're going to want the region above the line. And we're going to shade what we don't want as being below this line here. Okay? And again, pick a point and test that it works and it satisfies the inequality. 1, 1 is a point in the region we think is the one we've identified. Is it true that 1 is bigger than 2 times 1, take away 3? Well, it is. 1 is certainly bigger than 2 subtract 3, which is negative 1. So that makes us feel confident we've identified the right region R. And that's it for this particular video, other than to say one thing. What we're going to do in the next video is questions like this, where we have to draw 3 straight lines and identify the region that all the 3 inequalities hold together, not just one particular inequality like we've done before. So we're going to move on to this area. And that's where I hope you'll start seeing that shading what you don't want is going to become really useful. Because maybe at the point now you're thinking, why don't I shade what I want? Well, in these cases where there's a lot more going on, it's going to really help us to shade the things we don't want and leave the thing we do want as what's left over in the region. So check in for the next video to see this question getting answered. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching.